Welcome, dear student, to the very first chapter of history, that is Sources of History. Through this lesson, we will learn to identify the different sources which can teach us about our history. Children, what is history? History is the study of past. In history, we study about the past life of people. With the study of history, we come to know about reigns of various kings, how they ruled, their failures, their achievements, and their conquest. History also gives us an idea about the state of art, literature, and civilizations. Children, why it is necessary to study history? It is important to study history because it helps us to understand situation in the present. It also offers data on information of how people and societies lived and behaved in the past. With history, we can learn about the struggle faced and how our ancestors overcame them. By studying history, we can think about what happened in the past and figure out how to do things differently so that we do not repeat the same mistakes again. As we all know that Indian history is divided into three parts, that is ancient history, medieval history, and modern history. Ancient history deals with old Stone Age and civilizations, whereas medieval history deals with king and expansion of their territories. Modern history deals with the British rule in India. Till now, we have studied history of ancient, medieval, and modern India. This year, we will study the history of India in the post-independence era. Sources of modern history are different from those of ancient and medieval history. We can study history with the help of various sources like written sources, material sources, oral sources, and sources in the audiovisual medium. In the modern period, we have to take note of various sources at regional level, state level, national level, as well as international level. Now children, here the regional level means areas related to region of considerable extent. State level is a part of a country or a nation that comes under the state. National level, it refers to the area within the nation. International level, it refers to the area outside the nation. We can write history with the help of these sources. Written sources. Written sources are the sources that are available in any written forms. The written sources comes under the category of literary sources. Written sources are actually served as the primary sources in the research writing and are authenticated source of information about the topic. Different forms of written sources. We have different forms of written sources such as newspapers, periodicals, diaries, reference books, correspondence, documents in the archives, government gazettes, postage stamps, and encyclopedias. Children, do you know what is archives? The place where historical documents are preserved is called archives. The main office of National Archive of India is at New Delhi. It is the largest among the archives in Asia.
Children, Let us understand the first form of the written sources, that is newspaper. Just as newspapers are considered the fourth pillar of democracy in the modern period, the remaining three pillars of democracy are legislature, executive and judiciary. They are also a major medium of information. Through newspapers, we can get information about national and international affairs, politics, arts, sports, literature, and social and cultural affairs. Newspaper contains matters related to human life. Most national newspapers have started their regional editions. They publish supplements that give information about various topics. Newsletters of various movements, the dailies and weeklies of political parties, monthly and annual magazines are important among the print media. Some newspapers produce special supplements towards the end of the year that take an overview of the important event of that particular year. Such supplements help us to understand the important event of that year.
Children, let's proceed further. That is Press Trust of India, PTI. The Press Trust of India, commonly known as PTI. PTI is the largest news agency in India. Its headquarters is situated in New Delhi. Press Trust of India provides reports, photographs, and articles on financial and scientific issues to newspapers. PTI has now started its online services. During 1990s, the PTI started using satellite broadcast technology instead of teleprinters to send news all over the country. This material is important for writing the history of modern India.
Postage stamp. The postage stamps don't reveal anything on their own, yet a historians make them speak. Means, because of them, we are able to understand the several changes in the postage stamp since India got independence. Postage stamps reveals a lot to us about changing time due to the varieties of sizes of the stamp, the novelty in their subjects and the color schemes. The postal department issues postage stamps on a wide variety of themes like political leaders, flowers, animals, birds, and events, or silver, golden, diamond jubilees, or centenary, bicentenary, and tercentenary. Centenary means 100 years, bicentenary means 200 years, tercentenary means 300 years of different events. It is therefore a valuable repository of history. The word repository means a place where valuable or historical things are stored.
Children, do you know the postage stamp Jal Kupon? The Indian government issued Jal Kupon stamp in 1977. Jal Kupon started his career as postage stamp collector. He also edited Indian stamp journals. He happened to become the founder of first philatelic bureau in India, an office that collects stamps. He founded the Empire of Indian Philatelic Society and also went to write many books on this subject. He took the study of Indian postage stamp to the international level. He was an internationally acclaimed philatelist. The postage stamp on Jal Kupon is an important source to understand his significant contribution to this field. Children, let us understand what is oral sources. Oral sources is a field of study and a method of gathering, preserving, and interpreting the voices and memories of people, communities, and participants in the past event.
Oral sources include folk tales, folk songs, proverbs, ballads, and obis. Obis is a Marathi verse in the oral tradition. Activities were inspired by the powadas of Lok Shahir Anna Bahu Sathe and Shahir Amar Sheikh during the Sanyukt Maharashtra movement.
Children, let's come to the another sources, that is material sources. Material sources are those sources which comes under the category of architectural resources. In the forms of monuments, buildings, sails, coins, ornament, museums, etc. Material sources deals with physical sources such as coins, place of worship, things in daily use, royal seals, ornaments, museums, clothings, and modern architecture. Let us understand each one of them one by one. Coins. Coins form a part of material sources of history. One can comprehend history with the help of coins and the changes in the printing of currency notes. The coin from 1950 to those used till today tell us about the metals used for making them, their different shapes, the diversity of subjects on them together help us to understand the important contemporary issue in history. Certain coins convey the message of population control, whereas certain coins communicate the importance of agriculture and of farmers. Do you know the government of India mints the coins, whereas the Reserve Bank of India prints the notes? Temple architecture. The temple architecture of Indian history is divided into three parts, that is Nagara or the northern style, Dravida or the southern style, Vasara or the mixed style. Let us understand each one of them one by one. Children, let's understand the first style, that is Nagara style. Nagara is a style of temple architecture which became popular in the northern part of India. It is common here to build the entire temple on a stone platform with steps leading up to it. Unlike in South India, it doesn't usually have elaborate boundary walls or gateways. For example, Sun Temple and Khajuraho Temple. Children, let's come to the second style of architecture, that is Dravida style. Dravidian architecture was an architectural idiom that emerged in the southern part of Indian subcontinent. It consists temple with pyramid shaped towers and are constructed of sandstone, soapstone or granite. Some of the best examples of Dravida temples are Jagannath Puri Temple and Meenakshi Temple. Children, let's come to the another style, that is Visara style. The Visara style is the hybrid temple architecture. It has the feature of both the Nagara and the Dravidian style of temple architecture. One of the best example of Visara style is Hausala Temple at Belur. Children, let's come to the another form of material sources, that is seals. Seals gives us the information about the civilization. Some seals have human and animal figure on them. Seals also varies in different shapes and sizes, such as in rectangular, circular, or in cylindrical shapes. The seals even have the inscription of pictorial writing, which shows the cultural and civilization of a particular period. Seals were used in the earlier civilization and are important in their archaeology and art history. It is used as a means of communication and identification.
Ornaments.
Indian ornaments has a rich history that stretches through centuries, while there have been evolutions in design. Do you know that gold and silver were first used in ornaments because they were in abundance during Indus Valley civilization? The initial ornaments were simply made from beads, strings, and stones. Later on, people of Indus Valley civilization learned to make ornaments from metals. Clothing. It is said that history repeats itself, and it is not different from the fashion. Indians know the art of weaving and dyeing since time immemorial and glimpses of their skills. Paintings, temple architecture, carving, and other art forms clearly stated human wearing clothes in different styles. And this is the evidence enough to show that the Indians have been using clothes since centuries.
Children, let us understand the another form of material source, that is museum. Museum can be referred as a building wherein the objects of historical, scientific, artist or cultural interest are stored or exhibited. They enable us to understand history of place, period, era or an event. Each and every state of India has museum that depicts the characteristics and display the cultural and social heritage of the state. For example, Reserve Bank Museum in Pune city, whereas Chhatrapati Shivaji Museum at Mumbai. Apart from the government museums, some private collectors also set up their own museums, which are based on the distinctive subjects. For example, coins, notes, lamps, and nutcrackers in different shapes, cricket equipments, etc. Hence, it is rightly said that museums display the social and the cultural heritage of the state.
Modern architecture. Modern architecture still honors and upholds the tradition of India, but the architectural form work to better the needs of modern day society. Modern Indian structure didn't even start coming around until after India gained independence from British rule in 1947. Indian architecture was at a standstill in terms of progression. There was no unique identity being formed. However, when Indian Punjab government took on world-famous architect Lee Corbusier to design the city of Chandigarh, an architectural breakthrough began. Architects working in India began to draw inspiration from Lee Corbusier's work and thus began to more rapid evolution of modern architecture. Some of the best examples of modern architectures are Lotus Temple, Mumbai Airport, Chhatrapati Shivaji Airport. So children, we have studied different forms of material sources. Now let us understand another source, that is audiovisual source. Children, let's come to the another sources, that is audiovisual sources. Audiovisual means possessing both a sound as well as visual components such as films, television programs, etc. Various newsreels on important events in politics, social issues, art, sports, and culture can be broadcasted through audiovisual media. Also, documentaries on prominent social leaders, on people who have made major contributions for the country, and about important locations in India are shown through this medium. These news releases and documentaries are thus usefully for studying the history of modern India. It is hence rightly said that audiovisual media are an important sources for writing the history of modern India.
televisions, films, internet are also called audiovisual media. Many domestic and foreign television channels also come under this head. For example, History Channel, Discovery Channel, etc.
Children, let's move further. Film and Television Institute of India, FTII. The Government of India started the Film and Television Institute of India at Pune in 1960 with the purpose of providing public education. An institution called Indian News Review has produced various newsreels on important events in politics, social issues, arts, sports, and culture. This department has also produced various documentaries on prominent social leaders, on people who had made major contributions for the country, and about important locations in India. These news releases and documentaries are useful for studying the history of modern India. Children, till now we have seen some important sources for writing the history of modern India. The time in 21st century are changing so rapidly that even these sources will prove to be inadequate. However, new sources are coming forth. For example, during the transformation from landline telephones to cell phones, a gadget called pager came up for contacting people. But it died out as quickly as it had come up. The huge amount of information available on the internet is used for studying history, but the truth and authenticity of this information needs to be verified. Now, it has become comparatively easy to study history with all these sources, as these sources are from contemporary period, they are available easily. Since a subject like history touches all the aspects of our lives, efforts for preservation of such sources are made at all levels. We should also contribute to this efforts.
Children, in this video, certain topics are beyond the textbook, such as temple architecture, royal seals, ornaments, modern architecture, etc. These topics are explained only for your knowledge. Children, for the exam point of view, kindly refer the textbook.
Children, I hope that you all understood the chapter better. To know more about the lesson, kindly read the textbook thoroughly.